Hello everyone, in this problem I'm going to discuss another probability example. A car of brand X has a transmission which fails with probability 0.6 and brakes which fail with probability 0.3. The two kinds of failures occur independently. At any given day, what is the probability that exactly one of the failures occurs while driving the car of brand X? Okay, so in this situation we have two possible cases. Okay, so we can have one type of failure and the other kind of failure, and they will not occur simultaneously because we're only allowed to have one of the failures, right? Only one. Okay, so suppose that you have the case one, let's just label it as case one, transmission fails. Transmission fails. Then the probability of that happening, let's say P of T, is going to be equal to 0.6. Now notice that the transmission fails, but the brakes will not fail, right? Because this is when you can only have one of the types of failures occur. Okay, only, and not two, but just one. Okay, so that means that we have to calculate the probability that the brakes do not fail. And what is that going to be? The brakes fail, so the probability of B, the brakes fail, probability of B is given as 0.3. Now the probability that brakes do not fail is going to be the complement of that, right? The probability of B complement is going to be simply be found by subtracting 0.3 from 1, okay? And it's going to give us 0.7, okay? So the probability of T, the transmission, is going to be 0.6 multiplied by 0.7, okay? So that's the probability of transmission failing, but the brakes not failing. Okay, so that's going to be 0.42. Now, what is the case two? Now let's label that brakes do not. Okay, so that we're not talking about just transmission failing. Okay, so case two. Case two is to have brakes fail. Okay, and then transmission does not. Oops. Fix that a little bit. Transmission does not. Okay. So the transmission does not. And what is that going to be? So we're going to label it as P of B. We should probably say, we should label this T as just want to make sure that you're not confused. I'm going to be labeling this T with this mark here, B complement. Okay, T failing, brakes not failing. And in this case, we're going to say P, B is failing, and then with T not failing. Okay, that's another possibility of one failure only. Now understand that the reason why we're multiplying this, is because these two failures are independent, right? So failures occur independently. Okay, so that's why we must multiply them. So we're going to say P of B times P of T complement. Okay, so P of B is 0.3, And P of t complement is again found by subtracting the P of t from 1, right? So 1 minus P of t, that's going to be 1 minus, what's P of t? P of t is, where is that? 0.6, right? So 1 minus 0.6, that gives you 0.4. Okay, so this probability is going to be 0.3 times 0.4, and that's going to give you 0.12. So now we found two possible cases that we're going to sum up, and we're going to sum up because they're mutually exclusive, right? We cannot multiply the cases because they cannot happen at the same time. So whatever cannot happen at the same time, you simply add those cases, okay? So now the probability of at least, well, not at least, sorry, exactly one failure. Exactly one failure. Exactly one failure is going to be adding those two cases up. So going to be t, probability of t, with a c together. And then probability, adding the probability of B with T complement together. Okay, so that's going to be 0.42 plus 0.12, and that gives you 0.54. Okay, so that's answer choice D. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one.